see the speed limit now, actually people don't need to use their mind. They do what is said, like whatever the condition or whatever the weather is, they can maintain the speed limit. How about if it is mentioned, like instead of the speed limit, if it is mentioned drive safely? Now, you know, drive safely is a broad umbrella. It covers so many things, like you have to take care of the speed, the car maintenance, the kid's car seat, the seat belt, and there's so many things. Like now you have to use your own mind and your own judgment. And this is basically a difference between a rule-based and a principle-based approach. When a speed limit is mentioned, it's basically a rule. But when you have to use your own judgment, like drive safely, it's basically a principle-based approach. Let's relate this rule-based and principle-based approach with the historical test cricket and the latest United Airline overbooking issue. Okay. I don't want to go in detail. You remember the test match between Pakistan and England in 2006, the Oval Test, and the controversy of that ball tampering issue. Like whatever the umpire did, decided, was the adoption of rule-based approach. Like it was mentioned in the laws of the cricket, but at the end he was penalized just because of the adoption of rule-based approach. And like the losses overall stakeholders faced just because of that umpire decision. Same case with the United Airline overbooking issue. Whatever they did, like again, the same rule-based approach. Like it was against the customer satisfaction, but it was clear rules, it was strict rules. In both the cases, you see, the parties had faced losses because of the adoption of a strict and rigid rule-based approach. Well, both the approaches have pros and cons. Like a principle-based approach basically internally motivates you, like you do things whatever seems good and right to you, whereas rules externally compels you through threat, through force, through punishment, and you do what someone else has deemed good or right, especially the regulators. You see, in principle-based approach you have a big room for discretion and judgment. Like somebody gives you a broad outline and then you design your own building, you design your own structure. Also, the rule book and the rule-based approach does not cover every aspect, everything in life. So especially like for the customer satisfaction case and for the corporate governance issue and then many other, the principle-based approach is required. And that's why in many regimes, the combo is used, like the combo of rule-based and the principle-based approach. Anyway, thank you for listening and you have a very blessed day.